Good evening, all of you. Today's topic is Ethernet. Now, discussing on Ethernet, first the outline of this topic is the multiple access and Ethernet interruption, then Ethernet framing, then CSMA/CT protocol, then X-Wing backup. Next, we go for the first technique, that shared access network on different. Shared access network is actually used for the different physical layer link, and from that, can easily you can populate the different multiple nodes of the physical layer. It will include bus, ring, and wireless structure for the communication and the transmission sent to the node received to the all other nodes. Here, the point is noted: no intermediate switch is required for this control. It is a MAC protocol. Its performance is very good. It provides you the information to communicate with the short distance communication as well as the long distance. Here is a have a multiple access method like TDMA, FDMA, CDMA, that is time division multiple access, frequency division multiple access, and the different it's called cellular different of multiple division, a call division multiple access. Here the cell division multiple access have a important factor for detection of the collision of values in the example of Aloha or Ethernet protocol. Now we take the example of the token ring protocol. We have already discussed the token ring protocol, how it will be done. We are just going for the LAN architecture in the early 90s when this type of technology started to delivering the message in the proper destination. Before that, we go for the different types of Roger or different types of switching network for introducing different types of technique for delivering the message. But there is a problem on the switching network is that if you need a network is busy on the time, it cannot be delivered. But here the you have the option that it first fix the destination, then it from the source it delivered to the destination. If it not delivered, it gives a point why it is not delivered, and then it can easily return. So this IEEE 8025 stands for the token ring that I have already discussed in the previous class. Next one is our focus, why it is Ethernet. It is developed by a company in 1970 in the standardizing company, which have different techniques like 802.3, 3.UZ, different standard for the Mbps connectivity. The carrier sense it is used for the CS for the multiple access and collision detected until collision detected we stop recording or removing from that effect. Now, Ethernet central physical layer. How it will be done, it is shown here. You can find the thing is that the Ethernet that we are using, it has a transceiver station from that it can be received, and then it can be goes for the communication for the Ethernet sketch, then a terminator over there to communicate and destroy the layer. So next we go for the Ethernet technologies. We are giving here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 nodes over there. The five nodes you can find in a node number from the left to the second. The transmitting path will travel in the both direction. That's the advantage of this Ethernet. It can travel both direction. Then the T connector, then the terminator, the adapter is there to communicate to the node to the message. This T connector is actually help you to identify either this network is you want to send the bit that is to the network or not. That can be identified. Next, you go for the T-based network. You can find there is a network where we are just putting the hub T-based network where we can separate the network with different nodes from that we collected in the hub. It can be connected to the next hub. So it is a chain type of structure where we can communicate in a larger network in the smaller base station requirements. Next, we go for the physical layer. It has a cabling factor. There is a different data rate communication. Communicate with baseband, broadband communication network, analog signaling. It has a coaxial fiber optic network to the multimode fiber. Multimode means different mode it can communicate. It is a longer laser transmission mode also there. You have a advantage of fiber optic modes for the most faster communication that can be done by using this Ethernet. The overview is that it has a different bandwidths. You know that bandwidths have effect to the communication channel. It is 10 Mbps, 100 Mbps, and 1 Gbps bandwidth. Maximum bus length is 2500 meter, and then from that it can be separate the value, it can be control the value, it have a different access points to check the network values. Here the structure is given, it is a preamble, destination as a source address, the type of network, then you have to write the body depends on your message structure, and CRC, that cyclic redundancy check, it takes a redundancy, if it happens it will have giving effect. All bit are separated by pointing the number of bit it requires, but body bit we are not fixing, but it change on the depending on your message structure, but it have a fixed structure. Then the switched internet is a very important for the communication, for the long router, for duplex communication, it's a key separation, collision separately, it have a important factor. Then it will go for larger distance, higher link bandwidth, and much greater aggregate of that. Next we go for the Ethernet frames. We can differentiate the frame into small zone sector, then we go to communicate, then we have to send the fix it, multicasting the different environment we have. Next we go for the Google Alva network. We'll discuss this Google Alva network in the next day, so that we can continue the class and we get the information as well as possible. Okay, until then, goodbye. I'm just uploading those documents to my Google Classroom so that you can easily access those network and classes and with the lecture. Thank you.